welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all good. So as you can tell by the title, we've got a bit of a different video today because I am now a mother, so I am a dog mom. Louis! So guys, this is Louis. He's a little Bichon Frise. He's only 9 weeks old. I'm gonna let him go and play because obviously he's a puppy, so he just wants to have fun. So I'm sure he doesn't want me just holding him up to the camera, but I'll insert some little clips of him. I'm actually a mother, a whole mom, like what the hell. Right, so I've literally wanted a dog for the longest time. So when I was younger, my mum and dad's friends, they used to have a dog and I used to literally love it. So from way back then, I've always loved dogs and I was like, oh, I really want a dog. But when I was younger, I wasn't allowed because obviously mum and dad worked full time and I was at school and it was like, well, who's gonna like stay in with the dog? So we were never allowed dogs. And then when I was like 11, we ended up getting cats because we couldn't get dogs. But like part of me still wanted a dog. Like I just think dogs are so, so cool. And part of the reason that I moved to the apartment block that I'm in now is because they allowed pets. And I was just like, I definitely really want a pet because I've lived on my own for like 3 years now and it can be lonely. I'll be honest, it's been very lonely. So I was just like, nah, do you know what? I really want to get a pet. And I was thinking for ages, like, oh, let me just get cats because like cats are way, way easier and they're just easier to look after. And like, you don't have to worry about as much things with like cats. And then one day I randomly thought about it and I was like, do you know what? I feel like I've got the type of lifestyle where I could actually get a dog because I've been working from home for like 2 years now. So like, I'm pretty much always at home. I'm at home like most of the time. And I was like, if I go out, then there's definitely like a lot of people who would be willing to dog sit for me and things like that. So I was like, okay, let me actually look into getting a dog. So then I started looking into it. I was just watching like loads of videos and like trying to learn as much as possible because obviously it is such a big commitment. Like this is a long commitment. So I just wanted to make sure that I was definitely doing the right thing and that it was definitely gonna work for me and everything was gonna be okay. Like I haven't rushed into this like at all. Like I've been thinking about it for ages and yeah, I'm just so glad that I finally have a dog. But yeah, I've spent literally so, so much time researching into whether like getting a dog is gonna be right for me and like thinking about it and literally overthinking about it because I was just like, is this the right time? Can I do it? But then I was like, yeah, like I definitely wanna get a dog and I'm so glad that I do have my little puppy. He's so cute and like he's literally so clingy as well. So like everywhere I go, he just follows me and like he's always sat by my feet and it's just so cute to have like a little friend there. But it's Monday today and I got him last Thursday. I didn't want to like vlog the day that I got him because I just wanted to like spend time with him and like be present and not thinking about like, oh, I need to record him for the vlog and things like that. So I was like, oh, let me just like leave it and then I'll come and do a video after. But yeah. So yeah, as I mentioned before, he is a Bichon Frise, and to be honest, when I first started looking, I wasn't like too bothered about like what breed I got, if I'm honest. But then obviously I did have certain requirements. So I've got asthma, so he had to be a hypoallergenic dog. I did also want a small dog, and obviously at the minute I do live in an apartment, so I needed a dog that was gonna be like suitable for apartment living. So there's two websites that definitely really helped me out when it came to choosing a breed, and that was the Kennel Club like organization. I don't know what it's called, but I'll leave it linked down below. And then Pets for Homes as well. But yeah, on the Kennel Club website, you do like a questionnaire and like you fill it all in and then it gives you like a few examples of dog breeds that would be suitable for you. So like they'll ask you about like the size of dog you want, how much exercise you're willing to do with the dog every day, how much you want to groom them every week and things like that, where you live, do you have a garden, things like that. And then it'll come up with breeds that are actually going to be suitable for you. And so when I did it, I had quite a few to choose from, but I was like, I definitely want to get a Bichon. Like I just thought they look so cute and so fluffy. And then like I was watching like loads of videos of them on YouTube and I was like, oh, I actually feel like this is a nice breed of dog. And then also on the Pets for Homes website, it has like a list of all the different dog breeds that there are out there, and you can kind of see like what their characteristics are like. So it's like, how much exercise do they need? How much grooming do they need? Are they high energy and things like that? So yeah, definitely those two websites have definitely been really useful for me in picking a breed. And I do definitely feel like a Bichon really suits my life. I don't know. I feel like they're definitely a good breed for me because I feel like they like playing and having fun and things like that. But then they also like cuddles, which is just like absolutely perfect. Like it's a good balance. Like I wanted to have like a bit of both. So I moved into my apartment block in February at the start of this year. And at this point I was still a bit like, oh, I really want Mon, but like, am I ready for it kind of thing? Like I was still like a little bit unsure. So I was still like looking into them and like looking into breeders and things like that. But I was still a bit like, do I get one? Am I ready? Do you know what I mean? But then as time went on, obviously we got put into lockdown. Now I know a lot of people, well, I don't want to say like a lot of people, but I know a few people were getting like lockdown dogs, and for me it just wasn't something I was comfortable with, like, because I just kind of thought like I'm still not living like my normal life, if that makes sense. So like I still wasn't going out to like restaurants, going to the gym, going pole dancing and things like that, like all the little hobbies that I do, just going out and seeing my friends. So I still felt like it would be unfair to get a dog during lockdown, and then when I go back to like going out, going here and there, like what am I gonna do with a dog? Like, do you know what I mean? Like it just didn't sit right with me to get a dog during that time period. So yeah, I kind of just put it on the back burner. Like I think for me, I wouldn't have wanted to get a puppy and have it used to me being there like all the time, and then go to like, oh, like I'm gonna go out now and I'm not gonna be there. Do you know what I mean? Like, so yeah, I feel like from what I was reading, it was kind of saying about how puppies just like being in a routine. So for me, I didn't feel comfortable getting a puppy knowing that I'd be at home all of the time and then coming out of lockdown and then like going out here, there and everywhere. Like I think if you kind of like going out in bits and bobs while it's a puppy, at least it can kind of get used to that a little bit more than if you're just there all the time. So for me, I was just like, nah, like, let's just leave it. Like, we'll just leave it for a few more months, which I'm glad I did because I feel like it'll be easier for him to get used to my lifestyle now, if that makes sense. Although, to be honest, I haven't left the house for like 4 days because I've just been with him. But yeah, like, obviously slowly but surely I will like start going out and like leaving him a little bit. Like, I've got my mom like babysitting and things like that and helping me out. So yeah. So obviously once we'd come out of lockdown and I felt like, okay, my life's kind of like back to normal now, like I'm back into my normal routine, I was like, right, let me start looking for a little puppy. And then I was looking on Pets for Homes and I found a breeder who happened to also be in Birmingham, which I was just like, okay, amazing. So I found them on Pets for Homes and they said that their dog had just had 6 puppies that were going to be ready like the middle of October, and I was like, amazing. And I think at this point they were only like 3 weeks old, so I couldn't like meet him until like the week after. And then I went and met him and literally we just bonded straight away. Like, he just came, sat on my shoe, he's like really cuddly with me, and I was just like, oh my god, like this is my son. Like, I don't know, I just felt like we bonded, you know, more than I bonded with the others. But yeah, the breeder was literally just so nice, and because I'd been doing like so much research, I knew like what to look out for and things like that. So like the mom was there, the dad was there, like it was just like a really nice setup. She was like a really nice person, she knew a lot about the breed and things like that. She was like really cautious and things like that, so she wasn't gonna just like give the little puppies over to anyone. Like, so yeah, that was definitely really nice. I'm so grateful that we managed to find like a good breeder, because I know there's some crazy wayward people out there. So I'm just glad that like she was just like a really nice person, really helpful, really friendly and everything like that. So yeah, I was absolutely buzzing about that. But yeah, she was basically saying with her dogs that it was like an accidental pregnancy, because she wanted to get the dogs like spayed and neutered, but because of lockdown she couldn't get in, so it was like an accidental pregnancy. She wasn't planning on having 6 puppies, so it was all very crazy for her as well, which I think for me was quite comforting, because I was like, okay, you're definitely like not in this for the money, you're not just like breeding loads of puppies. She was like, this is the first and the last litter, and I was just like, okay, you haven't just done this for like money or anything like that, you've just literally ended up with a pregnant dog. So yeah, so yeah, I definitely felt super comfortable with the breeder, and I was like, okay, everything is all good. And yeah, I just knew that she was like a really nice person and everything like that. And I'd say, like, you know, you've got to like trust your gut instinct. Like, if you go and meet someone and if anything ever seems dodgy, then just walk away. Like, it's just definitely not worth it. Like, I think you'll know if someone's a good person, if that makes sense. So you'll just know, like, okay, this is a good person, like I can get a dog off them. So yeah, I'll make sure that I leave links in the description bar down below for things that you need to look out for when you're finding a breeder and questions that you need to ask and things like that. And yeah, hopefully that will help you guys out so you don't end up in some crazy situation. So yeah, on the day that we met him, I was like, okay, I definitely want this dog. I'm so excited, can't wait. Then I had to wait another 4 weeks until I could actually bring him home. So he had to be 8 weeks old. And like literally in between those 4 weeks, I was having to like order so much stuff. Like you have to buy so much stuff and there's like so much to think about. But yeah, like it has definitely been a lot. But like now I finally got him here, I'm just looking at him and I'm like, as if I've got like a whole dog in my house. Like it's just so weird still. Like to me, it's proper surreal to like finally have a dog. Like I genuinely thought like I would never have a dog. I was like, will my lifestyle ever allow me to have a dog? And I'm like, I've actually got one now. Like it's just crazy. So yeah, I'm actually so happy. But yeah, I just love when he like follows me around. Like I love the fact that he's like a little bit clingy. I'm just like, hi friend. And yeah, so on the actual day that I went to collect him, I went with mom and dad and then obviously brought him home. It was only like about a 20 minute journey, I'd say. They're about 20 minutes away from where I live. And he was really good in the car. Like he started to get a bit agitated towards the end of the journey, obviously. But yeah, he was really good in the car. He was just like in my arms like this, like looking out the window. He was just like super chill. And yeah, while we were at the house, we were just playing with him and just like running around with him. And he actually did like settle in quite well. Obviously he was still a bit nervous because obviously it's a whole new setting and like he's gone from living with like his other like litter mates and his mom and dad to like just living with me. So he must have just been like, what the hell, like where is everyone, do you know what I mean? But now he was actually really good, really calm, really chill. But then we'd have like loads of fun and we'd be like running around and things like that, so like that was really cool. But I'm not gonna lie to you, the first night was a little bit mad. And I feel like a lot of people say this with puppies about how the first night is crazy, because obviously they sleep with like their litter mates and with their mom and whoever, so they can obviously feel lonely at night. And then yeah, the first night when I put him in like his little crate area, he was just crying and like whining, and he was at the door and I could hear him like biting it, and then I could hear him like panting as well. Like it was really panicking me because it just sounded like he was proper panicking. Like he was literally just like and I was just like, oh my god, like what the hell, like I'm so scared. But like from what I was reading and like researching and things like that, it's best to just leave them because you don't want to like give them attention while they're crying, because they know that when they cry you'll just give them attention. So I was just like sat there in my bed like, oh my god, this is awful. He was crying for probably about half an hour, maybe a little bit longer, and then he'd like settle and be fine, and then he'd just be like panting. And I was like, oh my god, like this is crazy. But yeah, once he'd like calmed down and stopped crying, then I'd go and like check on him and make sure everything was okay, and he was completely fine. But I think because like he was panicking, but then also obviously I was panicking, so I was just like, oh my god, it's like the first night, I'm so scared and everything. So for me it just felt awful, and I'm not gonna lie, that night I probably got about half an hour sleep. The next day I woke up and I was so tired, like my eyes were literally like bloodshot red because I was that tired. I was just like, nah, this is too much, like this is too much. And then because I was thinking to myself like, oh my god, like what if the second night is just as bad as the first night, I was like, mom, is it all right if you stay around? And she did, and like she was playing with him like throughout the day and things like that, so that definitely really helped to have like someone else there, because it definitely is really overwhelming. Like I'm not gonna lie, like I think especially if you're on your own and like you've got to just like do everything yourself, keep them entertained, make sure they're all okay, like it is definitely very overwhelming. So if you can get someone to help you out, then I definitely recommend it, because it's a lot, it's definitely a lot. But yeah, the second night definitely was not as bad at all. Like he settled down really quickly, and like throughout the day as well he'd been like going in and out of his crate, so I was like, okay, you obviously feel comfortable with the crate. But yeah, for night one and two I think I got up with him like twice or something like that, because he had to pee throughout the night. But then on night three he like slept all the way through, and honestly, you know when you wake up and you're like, oh my god, I've slept like so much, like that's literally how I felt, because he just like slept all the way through and I was just like absolutely buzzing. And then yeah, last night as well, which was the fourth night, he was completely fine and just slept all the way through, and I was just like, but yeah, I'm not gonna lie, like after the first day I was just like, oh my god, this is gonna be crazy. I was thinking like, how long is this gonna go on for? Like, you know, you're just like, what if it never ends kind of thing. But yeah, like literally it's been completely fine. But yeah, through the nights it's definitely a lot better. I'm not gonna lie, I'm still not sleeping properly. I think because he's there and I'm just still like in my head panicking. I'm like, oh my god, I hope he's okay. So I haven't really been getting like my optimum amount of sleep. Do you know what I mean? Like I'm still quite tired. So if I look tired today, it's because I'm just so tired. Like I even had a nap like earlier. I was just like, this is too much. But yeah, no, he is settling in really, really well. But yeah, it's definitely been super tiring, but it's been so fun to see his like little personality come through. Like, he's so, so funny. Like, I just keep laughing at him like all the time. And like earlier today, he was like sitting on my lap and having cuddles, and he was just sat there like all peacefully. And I was just like, oh my God, this is like the cutest thing ever. Like, this is what I've wanted for ages. I just want a dog to sit on my lap like all the time. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, like literally it's been so, so good. But yeah, I started training him and he knows how to sit, which I was just like absolutely buzzing about. I'm trying to teach him how to lie down, but he hasn't quite got that one yet. I was teaching him stay as well, which he was pretty good at. I'm not gonna lie, he was quite good at stay, so I was absolutely buzzing about that. I feel like I'm doing quite a good job so far as a dog mom. But yeah, he's just pretty chilled out really. Like, he goes through phases where he just like goes completely crazy and he's just running around like wild. But then after that, like, he literally is just so, so calm. And like, if I'm cooking or anything like that, he just comes and like sits on my feet and I'm just like, oh, like, he's just so cute. So yeah, literally love him. So on the 20th of October, he has to have his vaccinations. And then like 2 weeks after that, I can start taking him on walks, which I honestly can't wait to start taking him on walks, because I always feel like it's in the morning that he starts going crazy. So I'm like, if we can go for a walk before he goes crazy, then that will tire him out and like he'll just be completely chill. But yeah, no, so far it has been so, so good. So yeah, I just thought I'd have to introduce my little Louie to the channel, because I'm sure you'll be seeing him around. So I didn't want to just be like, oh, here's my dog, like really randomly. So I thought, let me formally introduce him to the channel so you guys can get to know him. I'm thinking as well of doing a video about everything that I've had to buy for him, because I've honestly had to buy so, so much. So if that would be useful, then let me know. If you've got any questions, then comment them down below so I can do that whole video together. But yeah, thank you so, so much for watching. Really appreciate it as always. I know I haven't been very consistent lately. I don't know what's happened to me. I've just had a lot going on, stuff that you'll find out eventually. But yeah, I've just been so, so busy, so haven't been as consistent as I usually am. And yeah, it's been upsetting me, I'm not gonna lie. It's been hurting me, because usually I'm like consistency queen, but yeah, it is what it is, isn't it? But oh my God, I nearly forgot to say, Louie also has an Instagram account, which is just Louie C Miller. I'll leave it linked down below, and obviously follow me on Instagram as well at Leah_Miller. But thank you guys so much for watching, really appreciate it as always, and I'll see you next time. Bye
bye everyone.
Bye. How cute is he though? Like, he's actually so cute. He's actually sitting in my arms now.